I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Most of you are familiar with the 7-layer Mexican dip. I'm going to show you my version today. We'll start with refried beans. This is a 16-ounce can, and I've chosen the fat-free variety. It doesn't matter if you like just regular refried beans, that's fine. Or you can even get bean dip. But you're going to spread that on the bottom of a clear dish. And I usually use an oblong 8x11, 8x12, 9x12. It doesn't really matter, just somewhere in that vicinity. But you're going to make layers, and I'll tell you what the layers will be. After the refried beans, we're going to be putting some avocado, and then chopped tomatoes, chopped ripe olives, a mixture of sour cream, mayonnaise, and taco seasoning, and then some shredded Mexican cheese, and the final topping is tops of green peppers that have been snipped. So let's get busy and do that. I have prepared my avocados. There are two of them here, mashed up, and I have added 2 teaspoons of lime juice. If you prefer, you can use lemon juice. Doesn't matter. You need something tart and tangy that's acidic to keep them from going brown. And let's just spread this on here. You'll probably want to disperse it in a way that you can spread all the way from end to end. So just work on that and get it over to the sides if you can. It's a fairly thin layer. If you like more avocado, you can put in 3 avocados, but I think for all of the other parts of the recipe, it's nice to just use 2 avocados. Gives it plenty of zest and zing. It's nice to go all the way over the edge, because when you finish, you can actually look at the side and see all of those layers. It's not crucial, doesn't make any difference in the taste, obviously. But I'm finished with that. Get rid of this. And moving down the line, I have my chopped tomatoes. You can chop these finely or coarsely. You'll notice that what I have are coarsely chopped tomatoes. There are 2 of them. They're medium-sized. You can use Roma tomatoes. You can use fine ripened tomatoes, which is what these are. Any type of tomato, and chop it in any way you like. And I will say that I did chop these and put them in a colander to let the juice drain off of them. I'm going to see how much this is before I get committed to 2 of those, because I have more layers to go. I think we can use all of that. And just spread that out. As you can see, these pieces are fairly large, but you're going to be dipping with a tortilla chip, and you'll want to get a healthy bite, and this will work out pretty well. So that's fairly evenly spread. Next, we have our chopped black olives, or ripe olives, and these are 4.2 ounce cans. There are 2 of them. I'm going to try one and see what that looks like. I think probably we're going to need both of them. I usually use sliced ripe olives, and I think probably that turns out better. This is a little harder to get it evenly spread. You can even use whole olives. Just make sure they are pitted. You do not want to have an olive pit somewhere in there where one of your guests could bite down on that and possibly damage a tooth. You can see that didn't really quite do it, did it? So let's go ahead and take the other can. So we're using 2 4.25 ounce cans of chopped ripe olives. You just kind of dump those in there and then worry about spreading them out afterward. So we'll spread just kind of from the center outward and try to reach the edge if you can, just so you can show that there is a contrast in colors and layers as you look from the side. That looks all right. So So moving along, I have already mixed together the next layer. What it consists of is 1 cup of sour cream. I've used non-fat or fat-free, and 1/2 cup of mayonnaise. I'm using mayo-free. And then 1 package of taco seasoning. I've chosen mild. You can use the medium or hot if you like. Just blend that all together. We're gonna get a mixture that looks like this. Dump that on the top. You don't have to be too careful as you do the dumping. But we'll want to spread that nicely to the edges. We'll remove that. You really want to put the majority toward the center, and then you can go out toward the edges with the rest of it. And if it's possible, try to get all the way to the edge throughout so that you have a complete coverage, and anybody that dips into this will get some of each layer with one dip. So that will about do that. And the next layer to come is going to be very simple because we're going to put some grated cheese. I'm referring to it as Mexican cheese. It's called nacho and taco cheese. So that means that it's a mixture of cheddar and Monterey Jack cheese. And I'm not going to even measure this. I'm just going to sprinkle it along here until it looks good. So you just want to get a good coverage, and you won't spread this out afterward because you would ruin what you've done underneath. Just kind of sprinkle it in the position you want and you'll have it. So there you go with that one. And the last topping, we have snipped green onion tops. And that just makes it look really pretty and adds a lot of flavor right there at the end. So I have used 1 bunch of green onions, and I've just taken the tops. Now you do want to sprinkle this as well. Don't dump it and try to spread it because you'll mess up what is beneath it. And mine isn't perfectly even. You can take more time than I am here. But that's your finished dish. What we're going to do is provide for dipping. I have a sort of a tray here that I'm going to use. Let me remove this. And I'm going to pour the dipping tortillas in there. And what I have chosen are Tostitos. And I've chosen crispy rounds. So we'll just dump those in our side dish, as many as you like. And then you're ready to dip. So have your guests come along and dip down to the bottom. Get as much as you like, or as little. When you get that, bring it up and take a bite. Delicious. I think you'll like it.